Hello everyone. Thank you for joining also this session. I'm absolutely pleased to introduce Dr. Amami, who's joined us from Toronto in Canada. And Dr. Amami established this very exciting startup, AI Materia. And he'll be telling us today more about Materia Informatics, focusing on the theme of sustainability. As usual, Mariam, you have 15 minutes. 2 minutes before the end of your presentation, I will intervene. I know you can't see the clock, so I will intervene to give you the heads up that you have 2 minutes left. And then we'll take questions from the audience. So the stage is yours, and you may begin.
Thank you very much, Khasha, for the introduction and greetings from Toronto, Canada. My name is Mariam Emami from AI Materia, and today I will talk about material sustainability and how materials informatics supports the industry to achieve their sustainability goals faster. In the fields of materials and manufacturing, sustainability has moved from a public relation exercise to a critical factor for success in the industry. And now it's a business imperative. Companies have set ambitious targets around carbon neutrality, emissions reduction, increase energy efficiency and recyclability. But what do we mean by sustainability? Sustainability is a complex concept. The basic principles of sustainability were originally proposed by the United Nations in 1989, and their definition is the most widely accepted: to meet the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. Sustainability is a process, a holistic approach to development where scientific analysis should be used to guide decision-making for continual improvement in ecological, social, and economic dimensions, and recognizing the fact that all these three aspects must be considered together. It's the nature of sustainable development issues to be highly interconnected, and sometimes a benefit to one part could be deficit to another. Environmental sustainability is essential if we wish to have and continue to have the resources to meet our needs. Our most basic requirements, including unpolluted air, clean water, and fresh food, all come from our environment, as does the energy and raw materials that we need for construction and transportation. Environmental sustainability involves the entire global ecosystem, but principles can equally be applied to ecosystems of any size. A socially sustainable society is one in which all members have equal rights and all participate equally in decision-making process, and society is unsustainable if it consumes resources faster than they can be renewed naturally, or discharges more waste that natural system can take without degrading, or depends on distant resources for its most basic requirements. And similar to environmental sustainability, social sustainability principles can be applied to society of any size. And then we are talking about economy. Economic sustainability is about much more than the sustained growth of resources and profit margins. Economic sustainability takes into account the social and ecological consequences of economic activity. We need to carefully consider the full life cycle of our goods, from extraction of raw materials to their use and eventual recycling or disposal. So what does it mean to materials? So the same principles of sustainability applies to materials. A material will be considered sustainable if it globally balances use of the earth's material and energy resources, a profitable industry economy, and availability of affordable materials and products to raise the standards of living. So from the perspective of materials, sustainability requires attention to the way materials are sourced, processed, manufactured into product, maintained through the product life cycle, and redirected at the end of life. Materials have always been technology enablers. There would be no information age without silicon, no mobile phones without function.